Good morning and welcome to Ramona United Methodist Church and our Sunday morning worship. And we welcome all of you this morning to this worship. And we have a new adjustment to our sound, which I'm going to have to readjust here right now. So just give me a second. There, that should fix that. And that did, that's much nicer. All right, so welcome to all of you this morning. We're very happy to have you in worship with us, and we thank you for being here. We have just a few announcements before we begin worship with you. Our first is that we have our attendance available for you. We did have our attendance available for you. It disappeared, and there it is again. So feel free to use your phone and use the QR code there to go to our form and check in today and let us know that you are watching either live with us this morning, or if you're watching this as a replay on YouTube, feel free to use that and to check in and let us know that you're watching. We really appreciate that. All right. Also, don't forget that we will be having our midweek connection this Wednesday at 6:30. Pacific time, and so we invite you to be there for that as well. It's a much more relaxed version of it, a version of a sort of worship. We have a time of sharing prayer concerns. We have a Bible study based on the sermon from today, and a time of sharing stories, and a time of reflection, and just a time of chit-chat with the pastor. So it's a really fun time. I would really encourage you. It's the same link that you use to show up on Sunday morning that you can use to be there on Wednesday evenings. And I invite you and encourage you to be there and to join us on Wednesday evenings at 6:30 for our midweek connection. I also encourage you to help us out as we support our preschool by bringing them supplies. They are still in need of those. The preschool is doing better. They have now lifted some of the restrictions on numbers, and the preschool is up in numbers. They're allowed to have higher ratios than they were back in March, April, and May, and the first half of June. So the preschool is doing better, and they're happy, and the parents are happy because more of them can bring their children now to preschool. So they're all doing better, and we're very happy and excited for them. But they are still in need of disinfectant and spray, Lysol, and all those kind of things. So if you have those, or like I've always been telling you, if you go to the store and you see more than one bottle, pick up an extra one and bring it by the church, or stop by and bring it to the preschool directly. They would really appreciate it. This Sunday, somehow we didn't get a slide for it, but this Saturday we will be doing a very special event. And I have to give you a warning, we haven't actually gotten permission yet. So we're still waiting on permission from our district superintendent, but I am going on faith that we will get permission on Monday or Tuesday. But we are taking reservations to come into the church. So you see all of us here in the church. We are opening up the church to all of you to come on Saturday, but only by reservation. And so we are going to post that on our website. I've been a little reluctant. It came out in an email from the church late last week. And so it's been there. I haven't put it on the website yet. It's because it's not official yet. So I've been a little reluctant to do that. A couple of you have signed up, and I appreciate that. But we are going to open up to half-hour time slots next Saturday. I know it's July 4th weekend. To come in, spend about 20 minutes here in the church. Tim will be here, we'll be playing music for you. I will be here, and we are going to serve communion, something we cannot do if we come together as an entire church. But if you come in as a family group, we can do that. Now, if you would like, you can bring your own communion elements. You can bring your own grape juice and bread, and so you can keep it completely isolated and sanitary and, you know, just your own elements. I don't even have to touch them, physically touch them. And so you can keep them safe. And I don't know what the right word is for that, but but you can do that if you want. We also have single serve communion elements that we will have available as well. And so it's an opportunity to come here to see the stained glass, to be present in the sanctuary, and to be here in this place, and to see me and to see Tim in person, and to receive communion. Even if we come back as a church, we won't be able to do communion as a church, as a full church body. So I believe that we will keep doing this on the first Saturday of each month, or the Saturday before the first Sunday of each month. It's normally, you know, the first Sunday of each month is when we normally would do communion. So I'm hoping that we get approval and that we do this once a month and have this event available for you. So we are going to plan on doing it next Saturday, and then again in August and September. And so I just wanted to let you know that that is available. If assuming we get official approval, then you will see it everywhere. It'll be on our website. You will get another email out on Tuesday or Wednesday, and lots of advertisement will go out about it. You can call the church office on Tuesday, and Lori will help you make a reservation if you would like to do it that way. She is also going to be making phone calls to people who aren't technically savvy and helping them if they would like to make a reservation as well and to come in. So we're trying to do it and be as sanitary as possible so that even our most vulnerable population can feel safe to come in and to partake and to be a part of it. So I just wanted to give you a heads up about that and to let you know what we're doing. It feels a little weird to do that when we haven't actually received official permission, but it's just part of the process and how it's gone. Having annual conference be last week put a big delay in everything, and that's why we're sort of under the gun and doing this at the last minute like we are. Once we have permission, then we have permission to do it as many times as we want to do it. So that this won't be an issue going forward from here. So that's how things are going and how we're rolling this time. So, all right. So I believe those are our announcements for this week. And so let us now join together in worship and begin with our gathering song.
Savior, glory.
Please join with me in our call to worship. Welcome to each and every one of you.
Thank you.
May the joy we have in our Lord Jesus Christ become your joy also.
We see a welcoming presence in this house of the Lord.
Thanks be to God who has welcomed each one of us.
As we have walked through the doors to this place of worship, we now see from afar. We brought with us our cares and concerns, our joys and our sorrows. Touch our hearts and heal us where we find ourselves today, Lord. Make us ready to become your faithful disciples in whatever circumstances and locations we find ourselves. Amen.
Lord, we've come into your house. scripture reading today is from the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verses 40 through 42. Anyone who welcomes you welcomes me, and anyone who welcomes me welcomes the one who sent me. Whoever welcomes a prophet as a prophet will receive a prophet's reward, and whoever welcomes a righteous person as a righteous person will receive a righteous person's reward. And if anyone gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones who is my disciple, truly I tell you, that person will certainly not lose their reward.
The Word of God for the people of God.
The early Christian community took these words of Jesus to heart, becoming known for their many small kindnesses toward one another and to the larger world. Sometimes we expect to earn a reward by doing a kind action, and we forget that the biggest reward may lie in having the opportunity to be a kind person. In other words, the reward often comes before the act instead of afterwards.
In this passage, Jesus encourages us to recognize him in each other's hearts and to recognize God the Father in him. In Jesus' time, there was no refrigeration nor any way to make ice. It didn't freeze hard enough in the winter in Palestine to make ice outdoors. The only way to get cold water was to make a special trip to a well where the water would be chilled from being deep in the ground.
How are your hospitality skills? How good of a host are you or a hostess? Do you like having people at your house? Do you pride yourself on being a good host or hostess? Does the idea of people coming over to your house something that gets you excited, or is it something that scares the bejesus out of you? Our scripture today is all about being a good host. It's all about how we treat others and how we reach out in hospitality to others. So if the idea of being a good host or hostess frightens you, then today's scripture may make you feel a little uncomfortable. So our youth did an excellent job of sharing with us our scripture this morning and sharing a little bit about how the people of the day would have understood our scripture. The part that we would have thought the least about, the part about sharing a cup of cold water, you know, that would have been the least, right? Now, sharing a prophet's, you know, greeting with a prophet, and that, you know, that part is the part we worry about, right? I mean, how many prophets do you know? And I wouldn't even know how to greet a prophet the way a prophet should be greeted, because I don't know too many prophets. But sharing a cup of cold water, that sounds pretty easy, because I can just go to the sink, or I can go to our refrigerator, heck, and get a cup of cold water. That's pretty easy. But for the people of Jesus' time, getting a cup of cold water would have been the hard part. Greeting a prophet would have been easy. Well, maybe not easy. But they would have at least known what they were talking about, what Jesus meant, what the scripture was referring to. But getting a cup of cold water, that would have been work. Trying to find a deep well that was so deep that the water at the bottom of it would be nearly ice cold. That would have been tough. And we thank our youth for sharing that with us, to give us that perspective. Sometimes we miss the original meaning of these scriptures because we don't understand the context, that the people hearing the scriptures for the first time lived in and would have understood. But these scriptures are all about hospitality. How do we reach out to those around us? What are we willing to do? What are we willing to give to those around us? How hospitable are we willing to be? It is easy in these times to feel that there are no blessings at all, no matter what we do. Doesn't it feel that way? Doesn't it feel like nobody is being hospitable at all? Doesn't it feel like we're in a time of no hospitability? We're in a time where I went and talked to my neighbor, mowed, you know, our house is on a corner, so we are actually on two streets. And my neighbor mowed one of our front areas on our side street, which is not really the front of our house, it's really the side of our house. And I looked around and our neighbor was mowing that side of our yard. And I went out, one, to thank him, and two, to tell him that we're looking at getting our tree, which looks over both of our properties, that we're looking at getting that tree trimmed. And so I went out and talked to him about that. And when we finished talking, our inclination was to shake hands, right? And we both stuck out our hands, and then we both went, like this, right? Now, that used to be a slam, right? You know, you'd stick your hand out, and then you'd pull it back, right? Do you remember, remember that? Where you go, psych for you, right? But, all of a sudden we were like, well, we're not supposed to shake hands. Well, we're being taught today, right, that to not be hospitable. All the things that we learned about what we're supposed to do, all the normal things about being hospitable, we're learning are the wrong things now. Everything is upside down today. Everything is backwards. Everything is upside down. Everything is backwards. What are we supposed to be doing? How are we supposed to be interacting with one another? What does God want us to be doing in this time? Everything seems to be upside down and backwards. Well, God is calling us to love, right? And this scripture is calling for us to be hospitable. And we have to find out what that means. We have to figure out what that means in this time of COVID-19, in this time of social unrest, in this time where wearing a mask is the right thing to do, we have to figure out what that means, what being hospitable truly means, what being loving and sharing God's love in real and practical ways, what does that really mean? Now, one of the things Lynn said was really interesting, if you could hear what she was saying, was as she was reading that reflection on the scripture, was that what people learned was that you don't do things in order to receive a blessing. The blessing is in doing the good deeds. The blessing is in doing the good deeds, not doing the good deeds so that you get a reward. You see, when we think that doing the good things gets us the reward, that's where we get mixed up, and that's where when things get turned upside down like our world is today, we get confused because we knew what we did the right things and then we got rewarded. And now when things get upside down, we can't do those things, so how do we get rewarded? Well, we don't do those things to get rewarded. We are already rewarded. We are blessed because we are children of God. We are blessed because we are children of God. We are blessed to be a blessing. So it doesn't matter how we are a blessing to others. What matters is that we are a blessing to others. What matters is that we are blessed already. We are blessed to be a blessing to others. And the blessing comes as we are blessed to be a blessing to others. We are blessed because we are blessing others. And see, now it doesn't matter how we are blessing others. Now as the world turns upside down and we have to find new ways to bless others, it doesn't matter what those new ways are. We just have to figure out what they are. Because we are already blessed. We are already blessed. Our reward is already here. God already loves us. Jesus already died for us. The Holy Spirit is already within us. We are already blessed. It doesn't feel like it, that's for sure, right? In this time especially, as things go wrong, as things on the news seem to be falling apart, as the numbers of COVID cases seem to be increasing, no, it seem to be, they are increasing exponentially. We are blessed. In the midst of things going wrong and terribly wrong, we are blessed. In the midst of things going terribly wrong, we are called to be a blessing. And we must find ways to be a blessing to those around us. And the question isn't, how is God going to bless you? The question is, how are you going to bless others? The question isn't, what is God going to give to you? The question is, what are you going to give to the people around you? The question in this scripture isn't, the focus of this scripture isn't, what are you going to get? The focus of this scripture is, what are you going to give? Now, you can read this scripture either way. You can read this scripture all about what's in it for me? What am I going to get? How am I going to get my reward? But I don't think that's what this scripture is about. I don't think that's what most of Jesus' parables are about. Jesus' parables are about what we are going to give. And about how easy it is for us, not easy in the sense of easy in a day-to-day thing, but how uncomplicated, how simple it is. And I've been helping my daughter with math. That's complicated. This is not complicated. This is not algebra. Loving your neighbors, loving your enemies, it's not complicated. It's not easy, but it's not complicated. Bringing a cup of cold water to the least of these, it's not complicated. What are you willing to give? How are you going to be a blessing to those around you? What are you willing to give? Amen? Amen.
Please join us in singing Freely.
Jesus' name.
We come now to our time of sharing our joys and concerns. Well, let us lift up. As I mentioned before, our preschool is doing much better, but we would like to continue lifting up our preschool and the teachers and staff as they continue to work in this unusual environment and continue to be vigilant and in their care of the children and watching over them, as well as making sure that they are healthy and that the teachers remain healthy and that they keep care to make sure that that remains true. So prayers for our preschool in this time. We say, Lord, in your mercy, so let us lift up these joys and concerns as we join together. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for being present with us wherever we find ourselves this morning. We thank you for being present with us in whatever situations we find ourselves day to day. We ask you to be present with those who feel lost, alone, and abandoned. We ask you to be present with those who feel oppressed, who feel no hope, who feel like the world has forgotten them. We ask you to be present with those who are in the midst of war and chaos. We ask you to be present with those who are hurt and injured, who are sick, who are in overcrowded and overrun hospitals. We ask you to be present with doctors and nurses who are working long hours, who are working overtime, who are overrun and overburdened and exhausted. We ask you to be present with those whom we've lifted up here this morning. Reach out and embrace all of these people. Hold them all close to your side, that they all may feel your warmth, your comfort, and your care. And guide us, that we may reach out to in hospitality, that we may find ways to bring cups of cold water to your disciples and to all in need. Help us to bring peace and justice to a world that so desperately needs both. Give us strength and courage to find ways, new ways, to bring hospitality and hope to a world that feels like it has neither. And help us to remember that despite all that is going on, You are still the God of all people and of all creation. And help us to remember that no matter what we see on the news and what we hear on the radio waves, that we are still all your children. Help us to remember this as we remember the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We have come now to our time of sharing our gifts. Okay, not literally. But we've come now to our time of celebrating our sharing, and I again want to thank you all for sharing. You have been so overwhelmingly generous in your sharing. Our church is doing very well, and I can't say that for all churches, not even all churches in our conference, but our church is doing well, and that is most thankful to you. We aren't doing as well as we have done in the last couple of months, but we are still doing well, and we appreciate all the gifts that you have been giving. We thank you. On the screen are the ways that you can give if you still don't know them or if you've forgotten them. And so we appreciate that. We appreciate your generosity, and we thank you for that. The preschool, as we've been mentioning over different times, is doing very well also because of their increasing numbers. They're finally doing well. We also had good news for our the grant, I guess is almost what it is now, that we got from the government through the payroll, the PPP plan. They extended the amount of money of that we can use. So that's just about going to cover the losses that we had for March, April, and May. So we're very excited about that as well. It's been good news for us on those different fronts. And so we come in this time to celebrate the blessings that God has bestowed upon our church and to thank all of you for your steadfastness in this time and for the ways that you have blessed us. So we thank you. We do that by singing our hymn of praise, our doxology. Please join with us. Gracious and loving God, we are undeserving of the attention you give to the simplest acts of humanity and generosity. We are thankful for all the promises you have made and kept, and live in hope of the completion of the new creation you have undertaken as the kingdom of Jesus Christ. Accept our humble offerings and use them toward this mighty undertaking of the kingdom creation.
Allegiance, God, heart, and free. This is the
forth now with God's light, shining on the path before you. With Jesus beside you as a guide and friend, and the power of the Holy Spirit giving you strength, courage,